اللهم صلي على المصطفى نبي الرسالة وبحر الصفا.
What I would like to say is that the forces of evil and the forces of good have always been in conflict with one another. There has always been a fight between haqq and batil, between truth and falsehood, between right and wrong. And this fight did not just begin within our time and within our generation. This fight did not just begin in the time that we are living in, or in the century that we are living in. But this fight between right and wrong, haqq and batil, between evil and between good, this fight began from when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Prophet Adam alayhi salam. From that time, this conflict and this fight between haqq and batil began. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the first human being, our father, the father of the entire human race, Prophet Adam alayhi salam, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the crown of karama upon the head of Prophet Adam alayhi salam, who was to be the father of the entire human race, وَلَكَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي Adam, and gave him ishraf and honor, and said to the angels, said to the malaika, including all of the creation that resided upon the heavens, that all of you prostrate to Adam alayhi salam in honor of him. Everyone prostrated. فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ إِلَّا إِبْلِيسِ, except for Iblis. All of the angels, they prostrated to Adam alayhi salam. They obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they showed respect to Prophet Adam alayhi salam. But Iblis, the jinn, the shaitan, who before he became shaitan, before he was accursed, he was appointed as the teacher of the angels, as the leader of the angels, because of his ibadah, because of his dhikr, because of his worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the ulama mentioned that there wasn't a moment that he would not worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was not a moment where he was disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when Prophet Adam alayhi salam was created and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala announced that I will place a khalifa upon earth, I will place an ambassador upon earth who will represent me, that's when Shaitan said that how can you choose a human being whom you have created out of clay to be your representative, whereas I, who is better than him because you have created me out of fire and I have worshipped you for so long and I am the teacher of the angels, why is it or how is it that you can choose him to be the Khalifa, your representative upon earth over me? So he did not prostrate in front of Adam alayhi salam. So from that moment on, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you disobeyed me, now until Yawmul Qiyamah, you are cursed. You are banished from paradise. You are banished from my rahmah and my mercy. From that time, Shaitan Iblis, he swore and took oath by the grandeur and the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, قَالَ فَبِعِزَّتِكَ لَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ, that, oh my Lord, by your grandeur and your majesty, I take oath and I make a promise that I will mislead the entire progeny and offspring of this human being that you created. He took oath and he picked a qasam, فَبِعِزَّتِكَ لَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. And then he said, إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلَصِينَ, I will mislead his progeny and his offspring, I will mislead the humans, except ibadaka minhumul mukhlasin, except for your righteous servants, except for those servants of yours who will be sincerely in love with you, who will be sincere in their worship and their obedience to you, who will be sincere in their attachment to you. Only those people I will have no control over, because you are the one who will be protecting them. But all of those who are not sincere, they will be believers, but they will not be sincere to you. They will only believe to show other people, or they will pray only to show other people. They will give charity, but only to show other people. They will claim that they are sincere to the religion and to you, but actually, in fact, in their hearts, they will not have any sincerity. فَبِعِزَّتِكَ لَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. They are the ones that I will mislead. Those that don't believe in you and those that are not sincere with you. إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلَسِينَ. But I will have no control over those who are your righteous servants. Then what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in return to what He said? قَالَ فَالْحَقُّ وَالْحَقُّ وَقُولُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am saying the truth and I always say the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you have taken oath that you will mislead the progeny and the human beings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكَ وَمِمَّنْ تَبِيَكَ مِنْهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. That whoever you misguide and whoever follows you, O shaitan, whoever follows you, you and those people who will follow you will be your friends and your party. All of you will be thrown into the hellfire and earn my wrath. All of you will be in the fire, including you and the people who follow you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, on that day you will know what I am saying is the truth. So this is where this conflict between haq and batil began, forces of good and forces of evil at confrontation with one another. From that day when he took oath that he will mislead the human beings. Now you have to understand that it has become the devil's mission. It has become the shaitan's mission that when he was sent upon this earth, and when Adam alayhi salam, after making that mistake, descended upon this earth and the human race began, you have to understand from that day, it has become shaitan's mission until the end of time to take a group with him into the hellfire. This is his mission. At every moment of the time, that's what his mission is, to take people with him, to misguide people, to mislead people, to take them away from the truth, to take them away from Siratul Mustaqim. He is working all of the time. He is using different mechanisms, some of which you have heard in the lecture before. He is using all types of distractions that you are distracted from the dhikr and the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how do you become from the army or from the party of shaitan? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَانِ نُقَيِّدْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فَهُوَ لَهُ كَرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever forgets Allah's remembrance, whoever forgets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and turns away from Allah, then نُقَيِّدْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا. He will become attached to the shaitan, فَهُوَ لَهُ كَرِينَ, and shaitan will become his best friend. You forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we forget the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we don't pray, if we don't attach ourselves with the ulama, if we don't learn about this deen, if we are not sincere with the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if we don't attach our hearts with the masajid, if we have no fikr of the akhirah, if we have no inclination towards the deen, and we are away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and distracted in the dunya, then know that shaitan has become our best friend and he has been successful in his mission. And we have lost the fight and we've not gained the ultimate victory. So the way to come away from shaitan's friendship and become the party of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to begin to remember Allah, to begin to remember our Creator.